the most dedicated. The most dedicated, and it's clearly stated. The most dedicated. The best that ever did it. The most dedicated, and it's clearly stated. What's up, all my devil dogs? It's your boy Sean Lee, Strength Corps 9 Five Star General. It's 2021, so I'm not gonna go into, I wasn't here for however long. We're just gonna hop right back into the content that you guys love. So as you saw from the title of the video and a little bit from the intro, I'm just gonna talk to you guys today about my mindset going into my meet, which is next week. It's literally 9 days. 9 days out from my third powerlifting meet, and I think it's gonna be my best one yet. I'm really excited, and let's talk about it. So starting this meet prep was a little bit different because it was kind of an unintended meet. So as you guys know, earlier in the year, things got locked down, gyms were closed, and that was from, I believe, like March all the way until June. June, I started back at the gym just from the ground up. I really didn't lift. I didn't have access to any type of barbell, any type of heavy weights. I had a few dumbbells and resistance bands, but we all know that that is nowhere near, I guess, transferable over to powerlifting for the most part. So I definitely saw some strength loss. I definitely saw some physique loss just because, you know, the motivation wasn't really there. But I did go back in June. I don't remember the exact day, but I just remember starting from the ground up. I remember doing, you know, very lightweight and kind of just getting my movement pattern back, getting back into the flow of things, not feeling dead tired when I was leaving the gym, and just, you know, working my way back up to where I was. I then made a move to West Palm. As you guys know, I used to stay a little bit south of where I am right now, and I moved up here, moved in with my girlfriend, and you know, we have a really lovely place now, and we're just in a different spot. Changed gyms over to Boyden Barbell. I think you guys may have seen that in the last video. I believe I posted you know, me lifting at Boyden, which I love it. Love the environment, love the people, super dope. I then reached probably the strongest I've been. Like, I regained my pre-lockdown strength and then started to surpass that. It was almost like my body caught momentum from starting from nothing and just continually got stronger and stronger and stronger. The problem was my movement pattern was a little off and I started getting really bad knee pain. Like, my quad tendonitis that I have been dealing with for probably about 4 to 5 years now just got the worst it ever got, and I couldn't even squat. I remember going in and putting on 430 pounds into the bar, which at this point is rep work for me, and I couldn't do it once. Like, I did it once, but it was very slow. I wasn't able to go into the hole the way I wanted to. There was just a lot of pain. I remember walking past, there's a sign as you leave for, you know, for rehabilitation from a physical therapist, Dr. Joseph Rosie, my boy now Joey. And I was like, you know what, I'm gonna take the time out to do that. I did that, and within weeks I recovered. I'll have that covered in a separate video. I don't want to, you know, get to, you know, deviate too far from where we are right now in the flow of this video, but we'll definitely tell you guys about healing that up and just how that's taking my training to a whole nother level, both physically and mentally. And now I am 9 days out, so I continue to, I got better, redid some things in my movement pattern. I feel the strongest and healthiest I have probably in 5 years, since like 2014, 2015. I feel really good, and I just see the momentum that I can carry into 2021 and continue to pursue my goal of being top 10 in my 105 kg weight class in the USAPL. Speaking of which, let's talk a little bit more about that. So going into this meet, here's kind of where my mindset is. I do have a goal for this meet. My goal is a 1,500 pound total. I have gone from a 1,300 pound total in my first meet, where my squat was a little under 500. My bench was like 358.3. I always remember that. And my deadlift was like, I think like 512 or something like that, like, or 518, somewhere around there. And we all know it's a little bit of a questionable lockout, but hey, Tom Brady had the tuck game. I had my lockout first meet, so a little beginner's luck there. My second meet, I actually, well, prepping for my, what would have been my second meet, I smashed my toes. We all remember that, when I dropped 500 and, think like 50 pounds or something like that on my toes. It wasn't a good scene. And then I had to drop out of the Ray Williams Classic, which was last year summer. Then I prepped again and did my official second powerlifting meet in November of last year. Or of 2 years ago now, wow, November of 2019, and I totaled in the mid 1400s, things like 1444 if I'm not mistaken. I want to make the jump now to the 1500s, and I have some numbers in my mind. I have, you know, a few numbers I can play with here and there in the squat, bench, and deadlift, but that's my number one overall goal. And with that 1500 pound total, if I'm able to put that together, if I'm able to put together a 1500 pound total performance at this meet, I'll be in a real transition period, because now I'm not like a, you know, bottom tier powerlifter, but I'm not elite. I'm like right in that transition period where if I continue to, you know, if I take it, you know, kind of seriously, I might get a little better. But if I really start taking it really seriously and I continue to pursue it the way I have been, I have the potential, I believe, to be top 10 in my weight class without a doubt. If I really focus on a lot of things I need to work on and actually work even harder than I have been. But I'm at this period where like 1500 is not bad. If you tell somebody you have a 1500 pound total, no matter what weight class you're in, you know, people are gonna say that's pretty good. You're pretty damn strong. But I wanna be elite. I wanna have numbers where when people hear them, they don't believe it until they see it, which does happen sometimes, but not in the realm of powerlifting. That happens in the realm of the average. And I want to be known as somebody who has elite numbers amongst elites, not just really good numbers amongst the average, if that makes any sense to you. So I've been resting, recovering, eating really good. My weight is right where it needs to be at. I'm about 230 pounds, 231 is the cap. So I'm just, you know, continuing to eat the same type of foods, not overdo it. And this coming week, I'm gonna just be perfect. Probably do a little food manipulation just to make sure I'm a little bit under my weight and go from there and try to perform and get this 1500 pound total. Now, like I always tell you guys, I might go a little while without making a video, but I always come back. YouTube is something that I'm very passionate about, and it feels like the last couple of years I haven't been able to put into it what I would like. And you know, YouTube is something that I actually enjoy. I enjoy making videos. I enjoy posting for you guys. I enjoy watching my own videos back, whether it be the next day when I post them, or even years later, I'll go back and watch some of my old videos because it's just interesting to see where I came from and where I am. And I really want to get back to that because I think it puts me in a good place. I do have a lot of things going on. I have the Fire Academy I start in January, 2 weeks after my meet. I'm pursuing new jobs where, you know, I'm gonna have to learn a little bit of some different things that I haven't learned before. And there's just a lot of other things playing into it, and I have a lot of other goals, but YouTube is something that I really do enjoy, and I wanna make more videos. I'm not gonna promise any type of consistency. I'm just gonna do the work. I've told you guys plenty of times before, oh, I'm gonna start posting this and this on this day and that day. I'm not gonna do that. Actions speak louder than words. I'm gonna post the content. You guys can show me you appreciate it by leaving a like and a comment, and we'll just take it from there. And a subscription if you're not subscribed. Anyways, guys, I really hope you guys did enjoy this video. I'm really excited for my meet. Of course, there will be a meet day video, as always, no matter what. Even if I go a year without posting a video, if I have a meet, there will be a meet video. That has to happen. There's really no way around that. But I hope you did enjoy today's video. If you did, be sure to subscribe. Leave a thumbs up down below. It really helps the channel grow. Also, don't forget to click that bell next to the subscription button so you get notifications for all my new videos. And of course, don't forget to order, subscribe and share, like and comment, follow all my social media. Till next time, all my devil dogs, dismissed. Long as someone drink it, never drop the ball. Fuck it.